Hello everyone. Today I am going to teach you how to make the necklace. Especially I am going to teach you how to make that silver jewelries of Rajasthan, okay? You can make any other kind of jewelry, okay? So I am going to make that. So for that I have taken two different kind of clays which you can find in market very easily. Not clay, but it is like a substitute of clay, okay? So you can find it very easily. This is one, okay, Fabicryl. So this you can find in 20 rupees and this is in 10 rupees you can find this M-Seal. And both these packets will have two packets inside it like this. See, this one has two packets inside it which you have to mix together very properly. You have to mix both the clay together, okay, to get one clay. So these two different clays are there. I'm going to use it now to make a locket and some beads to make the to make this necklace. So for the necklace you can use any of the clay. If you are using black also it's fine, if you are using white also in fine. But in white what is the profit is there, that you can mix color in this, okay? So you take one piece of white color, white clay, then you can mix any color in it and you can make it a colored clay. The color you want to get, you can put some red color and then you can get red color clay, or you can put very little red color to get some pink color clay, light pink color. So like this you can get some colored clay, okay? So now let's start. Now at first I'll make the beads. So for the beads I'll just take it like this, okay, round, then I'll make roll it to make a very long thin shape of this clay, okay? Very long and thin like this roll of this clay. Make it equal everywhere, okay? Don't make it like thick somewhere and somewhere it's not like very thin. Don't make it like this. It should be equal everywhere. And then after that you will start cutting it. So I'll just cut it into small pieces. Okay, like this, see how many pieces I got, huh? So many pieces of beads also I will get from this. So all this I'll cut and small pieces of beads I'll get from this. Okay, now after cutting it I'll just give it a circle shape to this piece, okay? When you are making the circle shape, you can use this side, okay? Just this side of your hand on the clay like this, and then very pressing very lightly, you can just make the circles. So very round beads you are going to make. It should be very smooth and round. Okay, like this. So now all these small pieces I'll make beads, okay? now here you can see that I have made many of the beads, round beads, and now I am going to make holes in it. Now let's start making holes. So for that I'll take a normal bead like this, and then I'll use something sharp, like I have this thing now. Okay, so you can use something like this, like from a dhupkati, na, I have used this, okay, or maybe some pins you can use, huh? And also be like, you know, always take the measurement of the thread that you are going to put into the holes, okay? So the thread also, it has to be very, like, you know, of that size only. If you are making the holes too small, then thread will not go inside it, okay? So make the holes of that size of the thread only. Don't make the holes too small or too big. Check the size of the thread. So like this, I made a hole in the bead. Okay. So see, so many holes I have made. All the beads, this bead also, it has a hole. Like this, again I'll make a hole. Very softly and gently you have to put inside the stick to make a hole, okay? Otherwise the round shape will get spoiled, okay? The round shape will become something else. It will not remain round because it is soft till now, okay? So when you are making the hole, very carefully make the holes. So like this, all the beads are ready now. Now after completing the beads, I will move to the locket making. Locket of the necklace. So yeah, now all the holes are made in the beads, so I'll let it dry now. Okay, so it should dry. After that we can put it into the strings or we can color on this. So after this, now we will make the locket. See, now this clay has hardened. Okay, so it became very hard. So whenever you take out the clay, use it immediately. Okay, don't keep it for a long time outside, then you cannot use this clay anymore. So when you are taking out the clay from the plastic, you will immediately mix it and immediately you will use this. Now for the locket, again I am taking out new clay. Ensile I am taking out, and ensile I am going to use it for making the locket. So these are the two packets which I have to mix together. Mix it very well together to get one clay for the locket. Okay. And if it is too hard, then you can drop one drop of water, one or two drop of water, to make it little loose. So now my clay is ready. Okay, this MCL is ready. I'll just press it and I'll use this from the kitchen to make it little more flat. Okay, now after this I'll just use some lid of bottles to get a very perfect circular shape. Like this, and then I can start doing the designs in this. So this extra thing is there which we can use it for the designs, like just take out small piece of it. At first I'll just take this out and make all the sides nicely smooth. Then after that I'll start decorating on it. So for the decorations you can use different types of leads here. See, like this, with this I can make some more circle in it. Okay, one more circle, just a line of a circle. Yeah, like this circle shape we got. Then we can use more smaller size circle shape inside this. This design I am doing it by myself, a very simple design. You can do something else. Now I will just use a small dot here. Then I will use this refill to get one more small inside it, one more small dot inside it. Okay, after that I can use this refill only to make designs around this. Just dots I will make. So for designs you can take some sharp thing from the house just to make some very simple designs on the locket. Like here I'll just put some marks. Yes, so like this I make some marks all around it. Then on the outside this thing we can make some zigzag lines like this. So now after doing this decoration we can also use this very small round shape we can make, and we can stick it with the fabric glue, some glue we can use to stick it just below the locket. And also don't forget to make the hole. Okay, so you have to make the hole. I'm making it now with this refill, just pressing it inside the clay, and see the hole is here now, so that you can put the thread inside this. Thank you. now you can just put little bit of glue here. Fabricol, and I'm just putting it over here, right here. Okay, so like this I'll just put many. So like this my locket is ready. I just have to make it dry now. Okay, I just leave it for drying. Now after this is dry, after 2 hours this is dry, this locket is dry and this beads are dry. Okay, now we are going to paint this because I need a more dark black color, so I'll just paint it black. Both the sides I will paint and I will let it dry. Then I'll use some, like you have to keep it on some paper, okay, which will be, otherwise it will get marks everywhere. So I'll just keep it here on this paper and let it dry. Then by this time I will also color these beads because I need a very dark black color, so I'll color this also. Now how to color this? Okay, before I will just put some color on my hand. Yeah, now I will take this beads and just do like this. So it got all the colors now. And like this on this also. I will take some more colors. I think this is enough. So I'll just keep all the beads and the locket to dry for some time. Then after that I will color it with silver color. After this black coloring is done, I will use the silver color, okay, to make it a silver jewelry kind of look. Okay, you can use some other colors also on the decorations, so I will use the silver color just like this. So now it's giving you a traditional Rajasthani jewelry look, okay? Because Rajasthani people, they wear this lots of silver jewelries. And also on the beads, I will color half of the beads with this silver color. So I'll just keep it little far, and here I'm going to take the silver color and then just do like this. Coloring is done. Okay, now these beads are colored with silver color. Now we can put them inside the thread. On the back side also, if you want, then you can color this. It will look completely silver. Now after coloring this locket and this beads, it's time to put the thread inside it. So I'll just fold this, I'll take this thread like this, okay, like double these threads, then I will just put it inside this hole, this double thread. So that's why you have to be very careful with the hole, that you make the hole little bigger for the thread, okay? The size of the thread also you have to see. So now it is inside. Okay, now this thread I am going to put this like this inside, okay? This will become a knot. Okay, so like this it became a knot. Now we can put, I think I have made this in the opposite direction. I should make it here a knot. Yeah, it's fine, like this knot. And then after that you start putting the beads also, like one silver you can put, and then one black. Like this you will keep on putting the bead. So I start with black beads. One black beads at first, and then the silver one. Two silver beads this side, and then again two black beads. Like this you have to complete this chain. Again two silver beads, so two black beads and two silver beads I am putting inside. Now this side also I have to do the same. So after the black, two silver. Then again two black. then again to silver. So now it's ready. So now this necklace is ready. See, now I will just tie the end of this necklace. See how beautiful it is looking. So now I will just tie this end. So before tying this end also, we can put one bead like this, putting both the thread together inside the bead. This bead will help you to adjust the thread when you will wear it, if you want to make it small or you want to keep it long. So this is one bead. Now I will just tie this, and the extra part I will just cut it with the scissor. So this bead will help you to adjust the necklace, okay? So here we can just cut this extra part. It's okay if you don't cut also, but it will look clean if you cut. So now it's ready. See how beautiful it is looking. So you can make some other design that you want to make. Okay.